Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Freedom Prospecting. My name is Phil, I live in North Central Wisconsin, and I prospect for gold. Today we're back in the gold shop, doing something a little different today. We were having problems with our water, getting really dirty and muddy, stealing our gold as it goes down the sluice, I think. And so we've been doing some rebuilding, rearranging everything, put a filter system in there so we can take care of our water problem. And we've got quite a bit going on here. So I'm gonna get this turned around and I'm gonna show you what I'm doing here. So I'll be right back. And see how dirty this water gets. Look at all that sludge on the bottom of that tank from that. That's pretty nasty stuff.
That's good.
We're gonna pump it out and clean it. What happens is when you run that dirty water through your sluice, it becomes thick and sticky and real slurry. And I think it picks the gold up out of your mat and takes it right down into your tailings. Because we ran about, we were running buckets, and as the water was getting dirty, we were getting less gold and less gold out of the same material. In the beginning, we had over 100 pieces of gold one clean out. The last clean out we had 4 buckets with 1 piece of gold in it. Same material. And I think it's because the water was so dirty. So we're going to figure out a way to have a filter system here with 2 tanks so we don't get that dirty water like that. Because this is some real dirty, very dirty material. If you were in the creek and running this through your sluice, using your creek water to run through it, you'd always have clean water at all times. Never have dirty water going through it. But because we're recirculating, it keeps getting dirtier and dirtier as we go. We changed everything around so it's more efficient. We got the big tub down here. We haven't put water in it yet. We got our new sluice system set up over here with the high banker. We haven't got that running yet, but we will. And we got a filtration system here. We got one bucket here, a sheep cloth around it. The slit's in the bucket. Pump goes in there. Pumps the water up into this tub with the same thing here, sheep's cloth around the bucket with the water goes into it. So it's filtered twice. It's filtered when it comes out of this tank and filtered as it goes into that tank. So all your sludge, your mud and everything is going to settle at the bottom of this tub and any particles can't get through that sheepskin. So this can be filtered twice going into that top tub, should remain fairly clean water for a long time. Okay, we revised everything. We put a stationary pipe on there so nothing is going to come apart. That goes into that bucket there with sheep's cloth around it. And it's got a pump in there and it pumps the water up into a bucket up here that's got sheep's cloth around it, so it's filtered as it comes out of the bottom tank and filtered as it goes into the top tank. You got a valve on there to adjust the flow so it equalizes how much water is going from the bottom tank to the top tank equal with the water that we're pumping out of the bottom, the top tank. So it's just a matter of adjusting things and getting the level just right. And it seems to be flowing real nice. And I'm gonna run a little bit of material what happened is when we were, as we were going, the water was getting dirtier and dirtier, and it was getting all mud in there. And I think when it went down the sluice, it would grab any gold that was in the mat and take it right out into the tailings. So we got a bucket of tailings, or about 4 buckets of the tailings that we saved, and we're going to rerun it through here now and see if there was any gold that we did lose. And it might not be just in there, it was probably in the cleanup since we were losing most of it. But we'll find out. Here's all those tailings we saved from that last run. That was equal to about four buckets. 3.5-gallon buckets. So we're gonna run that. It's all clean now, it's been washed. Okay, let's run some of this. Going down the sluice nice. Equalizing the water level good. Something else I just did is put the rubber on there to keep that, it'll keep that gold coming down, material coming right down flat, dropping right in those ripples real nice. See it dancing in there? Working good. We got a visitor. Joe stopped out to see us from Ringer's Prospecting Journals. He's got his own YouTube channel. Really working good. I think we did a good job, Al.
It's great, John. I got here till 2:30 in the morning before blowing pipes apart. Learn as you go.
Yep. We got it figured out now. So we got this hibernator going. Got 2 goat hog mats in here. Another scoop of gravel in there, one. We got our water leak fixed, we got our mat situation fixed, and we got our water, good water flow. We got our water filtration fixed. Well, we got a lot done here, a lot of improvements. We got a water filtration system, put one tub up on a table up on top of the other one. The reason we did that is so we could save room, because he's got to park his truck and Bobcat and a side-by-side here also. So we got everything compact in the center of the shop, so vehicles can be parked in here, and then we pull them out when we're working. But we're going to have cleaner water for a longer period of time. We got the big high banker set up with two sluices on it. Both have a Gold Hog mat in there. The only thing we got left to do is get a 2,000 gallon per hour pump. Two of those, one to pump up into the big high banker and one to for the other tank that's pumping up to that tank. So they're equalized. Because it's got a 1,200 gallon pump on it right now. It's not quite enough water flow. Need a little bit more water. So we're going to the 2,000. Anyways, it's all working great and looking good. And we're gonna run some material and see what we can do. So I hope you enjoyed the video. And hit that like button, share, subscribe, and may the gold in your sluice be plentiful. See you next time. Thank you.